Snap! It's Lady D, Lady Carmella's mom. Now, you're almost probably wondering, what the hell is going on with the show? There seems to be a strand of golden hair in my mouth. Before anyone starts saying anything, if you're saying, Lady D, you're acting a little more like Lady Carmella. Well, considering the fact that I'm a mom, if anyone's ripping off anyone, it's her. Now recently, I had a breast surgery a couple of days ago. Unfortunately, all the juice from my boobs went to Lady C. So tomorrow, or whatever day she's going to be in the next episode, she's going to have twice the size of her breasts. What a surprise. That's why I don't have any bononkadonks. Literally, I only have nipples. Now, YouTube will most probably censor this. However, simply because my torso now looks male, I've got nothing to worry about. So, here's one of my breasts. They have shrunk so small, I've been mistaken for a man in drag. So, now the Lady C's been a naughty girl. Get out of my hair. It's time to get the show on the road, Lady D style. Now let's take a look at this desk. And would you look at that? A pack of fags. Let's pinch one. So, hold on a second. I was doing all this crazy punk rocker shit before she even did that. If you remember, for a long while, Lady Carmella was always wearing her hat and her boa. However, unfortunately, been since new to her, whatever I just said, it appears that she's now taking the lazy look like me. Now, we both come from the same place, hence why we sound the same pretty much. However, I'm more articulate than my daughter. Now, you're most probably wondering, Lady D, what's going on with your face? You look beautiful for a young woman, I was meant to say that the first time. I am 39 years old. I admit it, I'm an old hag. May not look it. There's a strange girl somewhere in this room who keeps looking at me, Lady C. Anyhow, let's get on with the rest of the show. Now, Lady C is resistant to tell you her age. Lady C is in fact 29 years old. So I'm hoping Lady C gets humiliated after watching this. So, I've got a list of things that I've been talking through. Unless they aren't that important, I will not do them. However, I haven't got a brain like a sieve like my daughter. So let's take a look at these YouTube comments. Apparently there might be some new ones. So I've opened up the Facebook and I've opened up YouTube. I do have to say I do miss my breasts. Simply because I do actually like shaking them around when I walk. So it appears to be, I don't think he has any comments on his YouTube account at the moment. It appears to be none. Right. Facebook doesn't appear to have anything either. Hang on a minute. Something going on Facebook here. Let me just have a quick read. There's an argument ensuing on Facebook, and I'm going to enjoy it. I mean, join in on it and enjoy it. Apparently, a couple are arguing on Facebook, and they're splashing each other's views on each other, and I thought I'd just share my views on them, even though I don't know either of them. So, let's close that down. Actually, let's open something else up because we need some white light. Now, looking on his MSN, appears that Eric is offline, so I can't talk to that man. However, there is another specific individual, and his name is Mr. Smith. So, I'm going to put you there. Forgot to press enter twice. Put the webcam there. I've got some words for Mr. Smith. I want to find out what Lady C's been saying to all these people. Now put your comments down below on this video, because I'm going to be watching this. I've been away for quite some time, not drinking Jack Daniels, and I was a bit annoyed that she was doing her shows in my house. So, I'm going to wait for Mr. Smith, Steve Smith, to reply to my message. Until then, we're going to do things a little bit different to what Lady C normally does. First, I need a puff of my fag. Now, Lady C tonight is out with her friends because I've encouraged her. And I was having a long chat with David, having a nice cup of tea, and he said, why don't you do a vlog? He told me the whole concept of it all, so I thought, why not? So what I've decided to do is I'm going to share my views and find out what my daughter's been saying. So as I said before, comments down below and tell me what my daughter's been saying about all these people and who she's been taking the mickey out of. And she's going to get some retribution. So Mr. Smith still appears to not be doing anything at the moment. So till then, we're going to have a look at something else. Now, unlike what Lady C does, I'm just going through the same miserable routine of checking Facebook and YouTube comments. I'm going to be in agony aunt simply because I've heard that there's a third guest who's going to be playing that role. Apparently the trailer for this character will be coming sometime in the upcoming week. So, don't seem to find anything, but David has told me that this next character is going to be an agony aunt. So I'm going to be answering some questions. Right. First question. Now David said he's going to give me a try. If I manage to do it quite well, I might overtake this third guest. However, seeing as there's already a Lady C, it'll be unfair to have me and my daughter competing for each other for the best lot. Now apparently this El Paparando is taking some break time because he needs to have some new work done with what he's going to be doing. So, the question is from Daniel Whitlock. And he asks, me and my girlfriend have been going out for 3 days now, and I think she likes me, but every time I go to hug her, she just stands there, and when I kissed her yesterday, she kissed me back, but cries because I'm her first boyfriend, and she is nervous. Please, could you help me? I really like her, but I want to hug her, and her to hug me, instead of me trying to guess what she wants without her freaking out or dumping me. So, and he's also put additional details. I forgot to mention, her friends say she is really frigid, but I still love her to bits. Well, Daniel Whitlock, you know what to do. You dump her! You go out with a fat slag. Or, I'll email you Lady C's phone number. I'm pretty sure she would love that. So, another girlfriend one. Let's take a look at this question. The topic is, that's actually the question actually, it's got some details in it, it's going to be quite hard to read this all, but a guy called Travis Lovell has posted the question, and it says, I've been with this girl for a month and a half, we worked together, that's how we met, so we started dating, and then got into an argument, and she says she wants to be single right now, she still texts me, she doesn't want to see me for some reason. I had been under a lot of stress from college work and now this. So I went up to her and gave her a hug, which she hugged back. And for some reason, I went in for a kiss and she backed away and made her really mad. It has been one day since this has happened and I haven't heard from her since. This girl means a lot to me and really wants this to work. Is there anything I can do? Well, Travis Lovell, if a girl doesn't want you to kiss her, then just back off. If you keep going after that, she most probably need you in your manhood and you won't have anything left. So this, the next question is the last one. It's quite a deep one. The question is, are you taking the piss? I've got to read all of that. This is a very long question, so I'm not going to read it. So, I'm going to read another question. Why does my girlfriend not like me anymore? Right, here we go. Now this is quite explained, so any children watching, you shouldn't be watching the show anyway, but parental guidance is advised for this has scenes of sexual nature informed in the question. So, here it goes. While we were having sex, I punched her in the face and told her to shut up. I accidentally knocked her out while I did that, and I thought it was awkward. So I left. She won't respond to my text message or Facebook messages. Do you think she's mad at me? Additional details, but she said she liked rough sex. Seriously? You punched a girl in the face and you call that rough sex? Rough sex involves both parties enjoying it, not you knocking her out and pretty much raping her. So what I have to say is, I like your attitude, Mr. Nick. That's for his name. So if you want to, try that on me. Trust me, it's taken more than a cinder block to knock me out, because I've had it done to me a lot of times. So that appears to be all the good girlfriend questions. Yes! Right, last one. My girlfriend doesn't want sex anymore. I'll help you with that. Now, seeing as it's Valentine's Day tomorrow, or today if you're watching it, or yesterday if it's the day after, or the Tuesday 14th of February, and any other day afterwards, this may help you for Valentine's Day if it's before then. My question is too long for me to answer. How typical. Right. Things my girlfriend and I have been arguing about. Here we go. Nothing keeps a relationship on its toes so much as a lively debate. Fortunate then that my girlfriend and I agree on absolutely nothing at all. Combining utter polar disagreement on everything ever with the fact that I am a textbook only child and she is a violent psychopath and we're warming up, then the fact of me being English while she is German, which is not only makes each of our personalities and absolutely responsible for history, and the social and cultural worse, I can't be asked to read the questions, so basically I'm just going to read out these things that this couple tend to argue about. Let's minimize that screen and read about what this couple are arguing about. Apparently this couple have been arguing about leaving the kitchen door open 3 times a day, that one, the best way to hang up washing, apparently, don't know what that's about. Apparently, the guy says I eat 2-finger Kit Kats like I'd eat any other chocolate bars of that size, i.e. without feeling the need to snap them into 2 individual fingers first. She accused me of doing this deliberately to annoy her. Well, I eat Kit Kats like that, I tend to finger myself like that too. You get more in there. Which, by the way, leads us on to the next topic of their argument. The amount of time I spend on the computer. Okay, fair enough. What's the point of putting that up there, you stupid twat? Our telephone number. The hell's that got to do with anything? Jesus Christ on the damn back. Firstborn's name, Jonathan, then she wanted to call her daughter Yasmin, even though it's going to be a boy. Right, that made no sense. She wants to paint the living room yellow. I have not the words. Well, then you could easily just tell her you don't like yellow, you thick piece of ugly spasticated shit. Next topic of what they argue about. She really overreacts whenever she catches me wearing her underwear. Why the hell are you wearing her underwear in the first place, you thick spastic? Jesus Christ on a damn bag! By the way, I had this ask before Lady Carmella, so no comments about me ripping her off. Or saying the same, considering the fact that I am her mom. Right, next argument topic that they've argued about. Look, if you don't understand the rules of Robot Wars by now, then I'm just not going to continue the conversation, okay? What the hell is all this shit about? I'm going to read 2 more, and then I am seriously going to go and get myself a dildo and 6 bottles of vodka shoved down my throat. I might swallow it as well. Wouldn't be the first time. The girl's called Margaret, the guy's called Mill. Right, Margaret says, hang on a minute. The topic of this is Margaret and I are going up a mountain, side by side, on a drive lift in Germany. The white noise of the snow under our skins is the only sound until Margaret begins to speak. Margaret says, "This woman, Hannah, is it? What's she like?" Mill says, "She seems okay." Margaret says, "How old is she?" Mill says, "About 30, I think." Margaret says, "What color is her hair?" Mill says, "Black." Margaret says, "Does she smoke?" Mill says, "Yes." Margaret says, "You want to sleep with her, don't you?"
"What the hell, Margaret?
Just because a woman has black hair and smokes does not make her easy to get to. Trust me, I've got blonde hair. I smoke. I drink. However, my family's got a noted history of sleeping around with everyone. Well, my daughter has. I haven't had sex for the past 52 years. I mean, the past 20 years. Didn't just say 50. Right. And the last thing these couple were arguing about, and they've got a lot of shit to get off, makes you wonder why they're together anyhow. The last topic of which they argue about, if I can find one that's less than two lines, she put, I'm waiting for the damn thing to load. Oh my god, they're getting longer and longer and longer. Don't want to read anything more than two lines. I was brought up not to read, but to smoke weed. Right. Apparently they've got nothing else to argue about that's worth saying. So I'm afraid that's all the time we have. Now remember, post your comments down below of what Lady C was saying. And next time I do a vlog, I hopefully should be reminded enough to read the man. So, for next time, this is Lady D. And I hope you enjoyed this little vlog. I'm sorry that my breasts aren't big today. Until next time, be gone with you!